Want to know everything about Google Stadia before you purchase it? Well, in this video, I'm gonna let you know all the details from pricing to the requirements. Google Stadia is an attempt for Google just to try to get into the gaming world. Yes, one of the biggest and most rewarding industries that is in the world. It's bigger than movies and bigger than music itself. So why is Google trying to get into it? Well, hopefully I can answer that in this video, but I will try to focus more on the release date, the founder editions, what you need to know from the pro to the base subscription, and much more. So let's dive into this video. But before I begin, I want to ask you a question. Do you think now that we have Xbox, PlayStation, and also PC gaming, do you think we need Google Stadia? Let me know in the comment section below. Also, I wanted to let you know that we are doing a giveaway. We are giving away a Recon 70 gaming headset by Turtle Beach. If you want to be part of it, it's very easy. All you have to do is click on the join button, or you can check out the link that is in the description below. So the first thing is, when is this going to be releasing? Well, what we have here is that the rumors, or the information that we have, is that it's going to be releasing sometime in November 2019. And is going to be available here in the United States, Canada, UK, France, Germany, and the major markets that it's being distributed to. So how is it that you're going to be able to access Google Stadia when it launches? Well, the only way at this moment is if you purchase a Founder Edition for $129.99. Yes, that is the only way you're going to be able to access. But you ask yourself a question, why do I need to purchase a Founder Edition if it's going to be playable and available to my Google Chrome? Why do I need a Google Founder Edition? Well, guys, the only way and the only reason I have here is if you want to play it and you want to be one of the first ones. That's the only way. If not, you can wait, and later on there's going to be two editions in which I'm going to be telling you guys more about it and break it down so you can determine which one you want to purchase. So what do you get for $129.99? Ooh, that's a lot of money. Well, one of the things is you get a Chromecast Ultra that runs for $69.99, and the other thing is you get a controller for $69.99. So as you guys see here in the pictures, you get to see exactly what you are going to be getting. So let me know in the comment section below, what do you guys think about that controller? Do you like it or not? Let me know. Also, I wanted to let you know, that's why you got to turn on your notifications, guys, because we're about to get some good stuff for you all. We are bringing to you guys a PlayStation Astro C40 gaming controller review by my boy LaserBolt. He's been testing it about for a week, and he's going to give you guys a breakdown like no other. So do expect that video sometime this week, or hopefully early next week. Okay, so now that I gave you some more information about Google Stadia, let's get into the different subscriptions that are going to be available. One is the pro version and the other one is the base version. The pro version will cost you $9.99 a month, and the pro version will give you some unique perks through the monthly subscriptions. So this is kind of like a Netflix subscription, but for gaming. So what does the base version of the Google Stadia give you? Well, one of the things, it gives you free access to the basic Google Stadia services. It allows you to purchase any game that is available in their store through the Google Store, and it also will give you a max resolution when playing games at 1080p, 60 frames per second, and it will give you stereo surround sound. But this is the only thing. You will need about 20-35 megabytes of internet speed. So if you guys don't have that, then this is probably not going to be good for you. Next one is the pro version. For $9.99, you're going to get everything that is available for the Google Stadia base. You're also going to be able to stream your games at 4K, 60 frames per second, HDR, and a 5.1 surround sound, but you will also need 35 megabytes of speed. One of the things, if you all have that speed, then you're going to be able to run those games. Second of available. If you don't have a 4K version and you are looking for one, I'm going to be bringing to you guys later on in a future video all the different 4K monitors that you're going to be able to run Google Stadia. So with your pro version, you're also going to be receiving exclusive discounts on certain games, and you're also going to have a limited time to be able to get Destiny 2 and its expansion. So for $9.99, that is well worth it. You get more than what you're getting. You're gonna have to be paying this on a monthly basis. So now that you know the release date, now that you know what are the founder editions, the pro versus the basic, now let's move into, are you going to be able to run Google Stadia or not? Well, if you have the following internet speed, you are going to be able to run this new service from Google. If you have 10 megabytes per second, you're going to be able to run the game. 20 or 35, you're going to be able to run the game. So for 20 megabytes, you're going to be running the game at 1080p, 60 frames per second, and 5.1 surround sound. And if you want to go the heavyweight, which is 35 megabytes, you're going to be running the game for 4K, 60 frames per second, and 5.1 surround sound. So question and answer, can I run Google Stadia if my speed is less than 10? That will be a total no answer. So you're gonna need 10 to 35 megabytes if you want to run this. If you purchase it and you do not meet those requirements, then you are going to be wasting your time, guys. So, and if you have any questions about Google Stadia, please let me know in the comment section below and I will answer them for you. Let's move on to the technical specifications of what do you need in your computer to be able to run Google Stadia. You're gonna need a custom 2.7 gigahertz hyper-threaded H86 CPU. You're also going to need a GPU that is capable of doing 10.7 teraflops. If you don't know what teraflops are, well, just think about it. Your computer needs to run graphics and at the same time output them through your monitor. The point of reference is the following. If your computer is able to output 1080p, then your graphic card is going to be fine and you're going to be able to run Google Stadia with no problem. You're also going to need 16 gigabytes of RAM to be able to transfer your game, and you're also going to need an SSD cloud storage. So there you go, guys. That's everything you need to know about Google Stadia. So let me know in the comment section below if you are looking forward to this new service, and if you're not, also let me know. Any questions that you may have, please write them down in the comment section below. If you found this video very informative, please give this video a huge like, and if you are new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe and turn on your notifications. You will not regret it here in the channel. So thank you for watching. This has been Tron, and I will see you guys on the next video.